What the new brain science is doing is shining a bright light on the fact that reducing child mortality in the poorest countries of the world is a huge triumph and then sets the table for the next challenge, which is now what do we do to improve the life circumstances and the life prospects for children who are still in desperate circumstances. And the brain science is there to tell us, for example, this is not just a matter of providing stimulation for young children in very poor countries. It's a matter of figuring out how to protect their developing brain from the stresses, the toxic stress associated with chronic exposure to violence, really deep poverty and the day-to-day stresses of just barely getting by, problems of parental substance abuse or domestic violence within a family, all of which we now know seriously affects the development of young children. Beginning before birth, prenatally, and then from birth on for the first few years of life, the body is growing at a rapid rate. I mean, so I'm a pediatrician by training. You normally double your birth weight. Under normal circumstances, you double your birth weight in 6 months and triple your birth weight in a year. It's a pretty rapid rate of development. And brain development is proceeding also at a very rapid pace. And the brain is actually chewing up a fair amount of the nutrition that's coming in because of the rapidity of brain circuitry. So obviously this rate of growth requires really, has a huge important requirement for adequate nutrition in a relatively critical period. It's helping us get a deeper understanding of why poor nutrition is so problematic, not just because kids are not growing well, but because their brain development is affected by that. And that both of those things, physical growth and brain development, have lifelong implications for learning, for behavior, for physical health and mental health. That's another message from this new science, is that the quality of the foundation we build in the first couple of years, it doesn't completely determine everything that's going to come later, but it either sets you up for a lifetime of good prospects for healthy development, or puts you in a deep hole. And says that the risks are now much greater that you're going to have problems across the board. The younger children are, which is kind of counterintuitive because people think, well, if they're too young, they don't really know what's going on. The younger they are, the more vulnerable they are to have kind of major disruptions of their developing brain architecture because of this pervasive sense of instability and danger. Because remember, humans are more helpless for a longer period of time compared to any other animal species. The way for this to be effective is for there to be a real sense of importance and consciousness about the early childhood dimension of everything that UNICEF does, right? Rather than say, we'll have an early childhood agenda and then we'll do other things. So there's an early childhood dimension to conflict and violence. There's an early childhood dimension to health, to education, to child protection. And I think that's the best way for UNICEF to embrace the science, is to have the entire organization be saying, so what are we doing and how are we thinking differently now in terms of the youngest children?